Life as a freelance illustrator is like an ethnographic film I saw in college. It has problems and it's not accurate. It's called Nanook of the North. And I remember the narrator is talking about, it's like, one brutal winter, one false step separates Nanook from death. You know, and like he's testing these ice floes with a spear, and then he jumps onto it if it's good to go. You know, and so like that feels a lot like what it's like to draw things for a living. Tragedy series is a culmination of existential sadness that one gathers up like treasure as you get older, and comedy that I liked growing up. Coming up with ideas 3 times a week is hard because I oftentimes will have commercial work that I'm balancing it with, and that's why I like the bike ride home. There's no internet. I'm not talking to anybody. I'm not checking my email. I'm just riding. The only thing I have to do is make sure I don't die. You know, and it's like being aware of my mortality on my bike is another thing that fuels idea making. I set little rules for myself. And one of those rules is no genuine tragedy. So nothing that's really happened to somebody. It's not funny if it's just like, your dog died. You know, that's horrible. And nobody likes that. Rule 2 is nothing after 1900. And the reason for that is that removal from a situation that comedy is tragedy plus time. If you have 100 years between living memory and the experiences of the things that are happening to people, it makes it easier to think about it in a way that's abstract. And I don't know what it would be like after 3+ years of doing it to think about stopping. And I really admire, you know, the way that British television or shows that are constructed from the beginning of their development with a limited scope. You gotta make things because you love them. And in some cases, you know, you gotta kill your darlings and you gotta end them because you love them, so that it won't just be this ceaselessly reiterated thing.